This might look like just a normal group of people, but they have a secret that could benefit us all. They're helping to unlock the mysteries of how our brains age and what we can do to stay sharp in later life. And they are the Lothian birth cohorts of 1921 and 1936, together known as the Disconnected Mind, funded primarily by Age UK and some of the research councils in the United Kingdom. All of them, when they were age 11, took an intelligence test. In fact, it was part of two Scottish national surveys of intelligence that took part in 1932 and 1947. That means that Scotland, uniquely in the world, has intelligence test records of almost everybody born in 1921 or 1936. It was the late 1990s when Professor Lawrence Whalley and I discovered that these surveys had taken place and that they could be useful. How could they be useful? Well, they could be useful because in most studies of what we call cognitive aging, the aging of people's thinking skills, we don't have a baseline. We don't know how people started out. And this is different in Scotland. We could actually, if we could find these now older people, we would have this very valuable and almost unique baseline of cognitive function in childhood. So we set out in the Lothian area to try and find people who'd taken part in the Scottish Mental Surveys of 1932 and 1947.
Well, my local surgery contacted me.
Some of my friends were doing it, so I volunteered as well.
I got a letter out of the blue.
I just thought it was a good thing to do. It'd be interesting to know the results as well.
We managed to recruit 550 people born in 1921. And 1,091 people born in 1936, and they are the Lothian birth cohorts of 1921 and 1936. They're very busy when they see us every 3 years. In addition to taking the same mental test that they took at age 11, we also ask them to do about another 14 mental tests or thinking skills tests. We try and give them a real assault course around the brain so that we test as many cognitive functions as possible.
When you go for your test, you're quite pleased that you've managed to, to do it once again.
Exactly.
And not dropped any points from last year, the last time you tested.
I think keeping your thinking skill, it enhances your quality of life as you get older.
Yeah. I took up being a guide at the Botanics 2 years ago. So I've got quite a few plant names to swat up. There are only 13,500 in the Botanics.
We're having to cope with things like smartphones and tablets.
That's
and computers.
Right.
It does keep us thinking.
In addition to the health and biological data, we appreciate there's a lot more to life than that, and so we're looking at lifestyle factors too. They tell us about things like smoking and drinking and activity and exercise. And we also ask about their well-being, so we're looking at social and psychological happiness and other factors like that. But the data that have amassed from the Lothian birth cohorts are literally going to take many years fully to examine. As we bring in new data every 3 years, it gets greater and greater, and it will take new technologies and new analytic approaches to fully analyse it. The Lothian birth cohort studies have done a lot to help us find out why some people's thinking skills and brains age better than others. However, I think the most exciting and many more findings are still to come.
Well, as I say, I've got two grandchildren and I would lay down my life for them. So why not be involved in something like this to help them, to hopefully for them to benefit when they grow older, to enjoy life.
To find out more about the Lothian birth cohort studies and the Disconnected Mind project, please visit the Staying Sharp website.